Hey guys, it's Harry from Inside Boxing Brain, and yes, you guessed right, we are back for another video. Today's video is in live reaction to the Tyson Fury Derek Chisora fight, which has just finished. Now, in this video, we're going to break down the fight, we're going to talk about the result and what is next for both fighters. I'm joined today by a group of my closest friends, and we're all going to be sharing our thoughts and ideas. So to open it up, I want to throw it over to Matthew to give me his breakdown and feelings about the fight.
Thank you very much, Harry. First, I just want to say both fighters, both Fury and Chisora, both experienced fighters, got huge amounts of weight behind them. Well, not the best of fights, but it's entertaining at least. Both of them, like I said, both really, really experienced fighters, got massive respect for both of them. Started off slow, Fury started to pick up what Chisora was doing, reading his blows, reading his dodges. Really, really good reads from Fury there. And it dragged on from there, from round two to round three to round four to round five to round six, All the way up to round 10. And it was a slow-paced fight at first, but both of them started to really pick it up after the fifth round. Massive respect for both of them.
I really agree with you, Matthew, because I think when the fight first started, you could see that Tyson Fury was just trying to use his ring generalship to really control the fight. He's got such a long-range jab. What he was doing is like flicking this jab out, and he was using his main right hand to sort of as a parry. So anything that was coming back from Del Boy, he'd catch it, and then he was using his left hand to throw hooks in as well. And what that was doing in the initial or early stages of the fight was causing Del Boy to stay confused, like he didn't understand how he was going to close the distance or how he could actually land clean, sharp, clinical punches. I kind of felt personally that a lot of the punches that landed were really cuffing punches with the side of the glove. There were no clean, straight punches landed from Del Boy. And I think as the fight progressed, you saw Del Boy's body language just completely change.
Depleted.
His energy levels were depleted. You could tell his motivation, charisma, stamina had all been sapped from him. And I think the stoppage that happened was, it was premature because the fight could have been stopped much earlier. Very poorly timed. And I think, personally speaking, Matthew, to echo what you just said before I pass it on to Aaron and Harris, I personally think that it was a boring fight. There wasn't actually any action that you could say that both men are really trying their hardest. Tyson didn't break a sweat, and you could tell that he wasn't even going through the gears. So all in all, great performance from Tyson in terms of ring generalship and demonstrating why he is the pound for pound best heavyweight boxer in the world. But I think it was a mismatch. Aaron, what do you think about the fight?
Well, I guess, they both got, well, they both showed a display of power, but it was lacking. Tyson, he held back a lot. Whether it's out of respect for Chisora or I guess it probably was. But yeah, we expected more action. The stoppage, like I said, premature. We expected a knockdown. At least a knockdown. Expected a knockdown before the stoppage, at least.
So an ample opportunity, for the knockout.
In the eighth.
Hey guys, sorry for the break in the video. We had a few technical issues. So we're back just to pick up where we feel like we dropped off. It was around about the point where we were talking about the current fight and how we felt this fight had gone. And we were touching on whether or not we felt that Tyson Fury was actually pushing the fight and giving his all. So a question I want to ask Aaron is, do you think Tyson was holding back in this fight?
Yeah, of course. 100%. 100%. We know what he's capable of. He's capable of stopping someone in the 6th, 8th. You've seen him do it before. He had him all over the place. He was rocking, wobbling in the 8th. And he just held back and eased off him. He came to see a fight and it's not what we've seen.
Yeah, I think we got a bit of a pantomime performance, to be honest, within the ring. You could see that Del Boy was physically tired and physically worn out. He looked shattered in the ring, Harris, so you agree he was so worn out and he looked like he was getting battered, even though Tyson looked like he didn't even get out of third gear at any point in the fight.
Tyson was sparring. Look, Tyson's got his eyes on the prize.
Yeah.
And, you know, Chisora was just another pawn on the board for him.
Yeah, so, stepping stone.
You know, end of the day, he's got his eyes on the belts. He's got his eyes on Usyk. And that's what we need to be talking about because that's
the future.
The future now, like, that's what we're working towards. So,
I mean, on the future, I think that, I mean, for the audience that are listening who maybe didn't get to see the fight live, after the fight concluded, Tyson essentially took the mic and started calling Usyk a little rabbit, a little midget, middleweight. And Usyk actually came and stepped onto the ring canvas just on the outside of the ropes, and they were face to face with each other, and Tyson was screaming in his face. But Usyk had that steely look of, I'm not fazed by this, which is just mind games. And I think that the Tyson Fury Oleksandr Usyk fight is going to be such a mental battle for both fighters, because it's clear that Tyson has the physical advantages. He's a bigger, rangier, stronger man with great boxing fundamentals and boxing IQ. So for a man of that caliber and stature to step in the ring with a guy who actually fought Sean Porter at middleweight in the amateurs and lost, I think that it's equally going to be a mismatch if Tyson does not hold back and make it a competitive fight. In terms of some other news, what do you think would happen if Tyson Fury was to fight Joe Joyce? Because equally, both men were at each other at the end of the fight. So just opening it up to the floor, what do you think the Joe Joyce-Tyson Fury fight would look like if they were both to get in the ring in 2023?
Personally, I don't feel like Joe Joyce and Tyson Fury have that same friendship as Chisora and Fury do have that outside of the ring. I feel like it would be a much more higher octane fight. Both of them would really be playing at the highest strength, the highest performance that they've done, really both playing in and outside of the ring, getting the crowd into it, and hyping up the fight, essentially.
Wow. Harris, what do you think?
More likely to happen than...
I think Fury's a smart guy, and I think what he's doing is he's using his platform to allow other fighters to come through.
Yeah.
So I think like what he's doing is not just like sports etiquette or sportsmanship. He's actually creating history. Like he's creating his legacy. If anything, what he would be doing is giving, you know, Joe Joyce
a massive payday, and a
huge global stage to stand on. You know, at the end of the day, it's not over till it's over, and it's anyone's fight once the bell goes. So you know, that's how I see it. But I mean, technically, I feel like, you know, Fury was on 30, if not 25% in this fight. You know, we've seen him with the greats, we've seen him in there with, you know, animals, bro. Like, you know.
Deontay Wilder,
for example, like, you know, the trilogy, like, that's when we saw him digging deep. Not dancing around and having
was sitting down on his punches in that fight.
No power behind him.
A question for Aaron. So, if you look at Tyson Fury and Joe Joyce, they're similar height, they've got similar reach. Do you think that fight would be a more competitive fight than the Oleksandr Usyk Tyson Fury fight because of those differences in advantages just nulling each other out? Or do you think one fight is going to be clearly more of a competitive fight than the other, and for what reason?
I mean, look, it's like, you know, Fury and Joyce fight, they're two different boxers with two different reasons for fighting at different stages in the career.
Yeah.
You know, Joyce is fighting to make a name for himself, you know, to build his career in boxing, so he's got everything to fight for. And I mean, for Tyson, you know, if he's doing it for the up and coming generation, then yeah, he's you know, he's fighting for that reason, but also to defend his title, I suppose.
Yeah,
absolutely.
But you know, Joyce was very hungry for it. Yeah, be hungry for it.
Especially at the end of the fight, he was.
Of course. Well, guys, thank you for tuning in, boys. Thank you for taking part in the podcast as well. If you viewed the podcast today, leave your comments in the comment section below, because we're really interested to know what you think about the fight. Do you think it was a mismatch? Do you think it was competitive? And what are your thoughts on Tyson Fury holding back? Thanks for tuning in, guys. It's Harry from Inside Boxing Brain. And yes, you guessed right, we'll be back for another video very soon. Peace.
Peace.